This is a rough sketch of the mould I want to assemble to cast my heat riser pieces. I've basically got a hollow cylinder that I'm going to use to form an inner channel which hot air will come up from the burn. And then I want to cast refractory concrete in between that cylindrical form and some outside form to contain it, and then of course that all gets taken away and I'm left with the concrete heat riser part. As I said, I've got a suitable hollow tube to use for the inner form. The outer form, I don't have anything. Now, I could just build a square box around it, but later on I want to coil some copper pipe to capture heat from the flue gases and use it to heat water, so the closer I can get to a circle the better. And so I plan to cut some slats of wood, each with angles along their lengths, that will fit together to form an approximation to a circle to make this outside part. I've gone for 12 slats because that gives a good approximation to circular without being, you know, without involving making too many parts. So in order to cut the slats on the table saw, they're going to look something like this. I need to know two things. I need to know the angle that I'm going to cut them to. So on the table saw, you set the saw away from the vertical. So I need to know this angle. And I also need to know how wide to cut the slats, because the wider they are, the further away they'll be from the centre of the circle and the thicker the casting. So firstly, the angle. The angle's very easy. I've got 12 slats. And there's 360 degrees in a circle, so I know that each slat distends an angle from the centre of 30 degrees. So if I draw it like that, this angle's 30 degrees. We know that in any triangle, the three angles add up to 180 degrees, and so the other two angles together add up to 150, and because they're both the same angle, we know they're both going to be 75 degrees. So on this diagram, that's 75 degrees, and I set the table saw at 90, take away the 75, which is 15 degrees. So that part's dead easy. Now I've got to calculate the width to cut the slats at to get the outer form of the right size. Now the inner form I've got is about 160 millimeters in diameter, so the radius is half of that, which is 80 millimetres. And I want to cast in about, getting on for an inch and a half, so say 35 millimetres. I want the thickness of the casting. And I've got some pieces of wood with a plastic coating on that will be suitable for building this. And they're 15 millimetres thick. So this total length between the centre of the circle and the centre of a flat is the sum of all these, which is 35, 40, 50, 130 millimetres. Now we can use that to calculate the length of this. So if I just clear, we've got 130 millimetres as the length of this side. I've made this so it's a right angle because this goes to the centre of the slat. We know this angle here because it's half of our segment angle, so that was 30, so this angle is going to be 15. And because we know the angle and the length of one side, we can calculate another side. If you remember your trig functions from school, we've got an angle and we want the length of the side opposite it, and we know the side adjacent to it, so the one we need is tangent. So the tangent of 15 degrees is the distance of the side opposite 15 degrees, which is our unknown, we'll call it A, divided by the distance of the adjacent side, which we know to be 130 millimetres. So to get A, if you rearrange that, half the length of our side is 130 millimetres times a tangent of 15 degrees. 130 times the tangent of 15 degrees gives us 34.8, so we'll call that 35. Coming back to this, we know that A is 35 millimetres and A is half the length of the side, so we know the distance we want is 70 millimetres. Because it's half 35, so we just need to set the table saw to 15 degrees and cut our slats 70 millimeters wide. Some duct tape to join them. And then the moment of truth, we see if they'll close into a circle. Inner piece is a piece of plastic pipe I've cut. I've made a slot in it because I've found in other castings it's almost impossible to get it out unless you make a split that you can lift it away from the inside. And that just sits in there like so. So the casting material gets forced into this area, and then when we demold, we end up with a nice heat riser piece. It's not quite free, let's give it a bit more tapping. It's kind of loose now, there we are. So we got that out. So although I'd cut a seam in that, unfortunately it's too tight fitting, and any little angles on the edges like that stop it being able to pull out very easily. So what I'm going to do next time is actually cut a strip down there. So the inside has still got some of the foil. These are the finished products. I've got my 6-inch opening and 12-sided outside, which is a pretty good approximation to circular. Now these just fit on. They'll be mortared in place on top of the burn chamber, like so. And that gives us the overall impression. There's a look into the burn chamber. And there's a look down the heat riser.